Hey guys, today I'm gonna bounce around a little bit. Anything new I show my high school team, it might not be a new technique, but anything I work with my high school team, guys, I wanna show you. We're working on this kind of newer ride, and I'll get to that. And then I wanna show you what my son Bo and what my little son Mickey, I've got three boys, what they do on top. So I wanna get through that, then I wanna spend most of the time, guys, on a head inside single. Real quick for you guys, Mario. On a head inside single, guys, this is our best shot at Graham High School. I think most of you guys know I coached at Graham High School. We're pretty tough. We won the state the last 15 years in a row. We won three national titles. This is our best shot right here, the head inside. All right. Now, one thing on the head inside, all right, is this. Mario has three options to do, and only three. All right. Always, always, always. Option number one, he's going to push right. Why? His offensive score increased dramatically. I'm on one leg, I'm on two. You guys with me? So that's always option number one. Option number two is this, guys. If Mario can't do option one and get to his feet, Mario's gonna try to get an angle here, he's gonna try to step in, he's gonna try to chase this far lead right now. That's always option number two. We call that a head inside single chase the angle. That's one of more state titles, option two, than any other move, I promise. There only needs one more option. Option three says, if you can't get to your feet on option one, you can't head south and chase that far lead on option number two. Mario's either got to go to another finish right away or get the freak out of there so I don't care the way he'll sprawl. Does that make sense, guys? We're going. I wish we could get to option three, but I don't think we'll have time. So we're going to option number two. Probably about an hour. It'll take us an hour to get to option they did a study. Guys, I've been teaching a head inside single, guys, for about 30 years of my life. Like every year, I think, a little bit better than teaching it than the year before. One little thing I can figure out, guys, when I do it, I make sure I explain it. But, guys, they did a study 2 years ago. There's a 2-year study in the national tournament, the NCAA tournament for wrestling. All right, they did a study in 2013 and 2014, those 2 years. And here's what they said. What did the national champ do to beat the NCAA runner-up in the finals, the national tournament? What did he score with? All right, what the national champ did to become a national champ to beat the NCAA runner-up. There's 20 guys in the national finals. There's 10 weight classes. There's 10 champions. So what did the champion do? The runner-up. And what's amazing, guys, I got 75 texts, probably about 75 emails on, Coach Jordan, you're right. You're going to love this graph. The number one takedown the national champ did in the NCAA runner-up was a head inside single. All right, that was number one. Number two, guys, shocked me. I thought number two was going to be a front headline. All right, it was number three. Anybody know what number two was? You guys came to camp last year. I told you guys. Anybody know what number two is? I'll give you a hint, guys. David Taylor. I think what his big move is? Ankle pick. Shot. Ankle pick was number two. Number three was the front headlock. Number four, I think, was a double pick. Number five, guys, was a something off number. I think number six was the head outside single. All right. Hey, guys, there's 3 seconds left in the match. 3 seconds left in the match. Mario's down 5 points. He looks over at me. I go, Mario, hit it now. I'm talking about the head inside single. Why would I tell him to hit this shot? All right. Instead of this shot. Guys, I'm just trying to make you guys think a little bit. Wrestling's not that difficult. Why don't I come head inside instead of head outside?
Percent of the time you cross face, you get like space between you.
You're saying I can cross face him?
Yeah.
He's on the right page, guys, what I'm getting at. He's getting to the right page. Yes. All right. It's easier to defend a head outside single than it is a head inside single. Hey guys, here's the head outside single. I can cross face. I can net wrench. I can back pull. Dave Schultz should just squat down and block the elbow. I can sprawl. The big one, guys, with 20 seconds left is this right here. I think I can pull Mario off if I go this crackdown position, whether I need a shoulder or whether I don't need a shoulder. Does that make sense, guys? When I head inside, guys, I really have one option. Head inside single, I have one option, and that's sprawl. Does that make sense? All right. So I'm going to spend the next hour, guys, from 3 to 4. We're going to spend all that time on the head inside single. All right, I want to show you some new technique I'm doing right now with my guys. All right, that's newer to my team, and we'll see what I'll get to. Any questions?